I want to welcome and thank you for being here today to talk about this important issue. Senator Costa, Representative Gainey, you'll be hearing from shortly. We also are joined by State Senator Lindsey Williams and our school board member Linda Wren. I don't see anybody else, I think, here. These have been steadfast allies and good friends as we have worked on ways to find a better way to protect Pennsylvanians in the aftermath of the attack that took place here. Again, I want to thank Rabbi Jeffrey Myers, who leads Tree of Life Or LaSimcha, for coming today and allowing us to be here. Rabbi Myers has helped guide our entire community through this difficult time. We stand here today on sacred ground. The horrors that occurred here will never be forgotten. 11 lives were cut short, and countless others have been forever changed. Today we are announcing the introduction of our legislative package to combat hate crimes. These bills will expand and update our outdated laws so they can protect LGBTQ and disabled people, increase civil and criminal penalties for hate crimes, provide education for those who have been convicted of these crimes, and improve the data for tracking hate crimes and hate criminals. An attack on an individual or a group because of who they are, who they love, what they believe, or how they pray victimizes both the immediate target and of the crime and the larger community. It's an attack on these groups' sense of security and their connection to the world around them. The penalties that these perpetrators suffer should reflect both crimes. So, you know, it's very different when you're talking about somebody who's defacing a street sign with graffiti as opposed to putting a swastika on a synagogue. They need to be treated differently, and these hate crime laws will do that and hold people accountable. Reported and hated hate crimes are increasing in our state and throughout the nation and the world, but we know that those statistics include a tiny fraction of the hate crimes that are actually occurring. That's why this package would both educate police officers to properly identify hate crimes and make it easier for college students in particular to report them. After the attack on the Jewish community in Pittsburgh, a surge of love and support enveloped us. People of every faith, walk of life, reached out and found ways to offer support and combat the fears that creep in after a hate crime. This overwhelming response showed the world that our city and our state stand for love, acceptance, and acceptance, not hatred. It's time to make sure that our laws do the same.